Hi, my name is Nick Homenda, and I am one of the co-facilitators of the Digital Library Pedagogy Working Group, commonly referred to as DLF Teach. Our group was founded in 2015 and is focused on building a community of practice for those interested in using digital library collections and technologies in their pedagogy practice. This group is open for anyone to join, regardless of your position, academic discipline, or DLF institutional affiliation. We are an extremely welcoming group, and we primarily work on projects with some ongoing initiatives as well. I've been involved since 2018, and I can say it's a great group for meeting and working with other people working on digital library instruction. And this group has shaped the way I approach my own position as digital initiatives librarian at Indiana University. Over to you, Heidi.
Thanks, Nick. I'm Heidi Winkler, co-facilitator of DLF Teach. When we asked DLF Teach members to tell us how people describe this working group in one word, we had some great responses. Some members expanded on their word, and they expressed that DLF Teach is a place where we can learn from others and share professional knowledge as it develops. With another adding, this is a really accessible group to join, no matter type or level of expertise. One member said, "This group gives me solid and actionable tips and techniques I can use in my instruction. I've used elements of the DLF Teach toolkit in my teaching multiple times, and it's so useful to have connections with people who have a role similar to mine. A lot of writing and online resources about teaching is so abstract and more related to information literacy that I greatly appreciate DLF Teach's down-to-earth and practical approach to effective teaching." That was from Kayla Abner. What's unique about DLF Teach? Well, here's what member Maura Seal said. "I like that it's project driven. I also like that it's accessible even if your institution isn't a DLF member. Someone described the work processes as radically inclusive, constantly seeking feedback from other DLF Teach members, making meetings public, and so on. This can be challenging in moving projects forward, but I have appreciated how the process can bring in new members throughout the life cycle of the project. And for me, someone who is passionate about talking to academic library patrons about digital libraries and scholarly communications, I love DLF Teach's Twitter chat because they give me ideas I can immediately apply to my day-to-day work." Over to you, Martha.
Thanks, Heidi. I'm Martha Stite, the current coordinator for the Twitter chat. So one way to participate in DLF Teach is through our Twitter chats every other month. At the scheduled time, you can follow our hashtag and join a conversation with colleagues from different institutions on Twitter. Over the course of the hour, questions will be tweeted from the @ClearDLF account. You may follow, tweet, and reply from your own account, making sure to include the hashtag DLF Teach. Each time, there are chat hosts who have agreed to lead the conversation, and they are volunteers who switch out each chat. They put together the discussion questions on the topic ahead of time. You might be wondering what we talk about. Topics change each month. Past and upcoming topics have included instructional design, collaboration, anti-racism, data, and privacy, all through the lens of instruction and digital technology. These are very active conversations where you can learn from people in a range of positions and subjects. So do you want to find out when the next chats are and what their topics are? Follow the hashtag DLFTeach for announcements, or join our Google group called DLF Pedagogy, and the email address will display at the end of this video. Have an idea for a chat topic? Let us know too. So join us, we hope to see you there. And now I'm going to send it over to you, Alex.
Thanks, Martha. Hi everyone, I'm Alex from Mercolin, and I'm a recent member of DLF Teach. I've had the pleasure of working with some of my former CLEAR postdoctoral fellows, as well as DLF Teach members, to start editing volume 2 of DLF Teach Toolkit. DLF Teach Toolkit 1.0 is currently available, open access online, if you want to take a look at the types of lesson plans they've developed in the past. This round of DLF Teach Toolkit will focus on immersive technologies, including 360 video and VR for the classroom. If you're interested in submitting a lesson plan, we are accepting submissions throughout the fall. call on a rolling basis and are trying to make the editing process accommodating during this difficult time. At the end of this video, you'll see a link to the wiki where you can access the CFP. Over to you, Nick.
Thanks, Alex. Viewers, please consider joining us. There is really no barrier to entry in our group, and you will have many opportunities to grow our community of practitioners and help create a positive impact. Here's how to get involved. First, you can check out our group's website at www.diglib.org/groups/digital-library-pedagogy. Also, you can check out our wiki to get up-to-date information on what we're up to. You can join our Google group to get on our mailing list. And be sure to save the date for our next DLF Teach Twitter chat on Tuesday, December 15th at 2 p.m. Eastern, where we will discuss the topic, Reflecting on Digital Library Pedagogy in a Strange 2020, and what can DLF Teach do in 2021 to support our community? We hope to see you there.